There's a tendency in science to distinguish between the physical sciences and the life sciences, and between things that are alive, like us, and things that are not alive, like chemistry, physics, laws of motion, from microscopic scale of atoms to the cosmic scale of galaxies and planets and the universe as a whole. Our whole world runs on physics. When you pick up your cell phone, you're using physics at every level, from the electronics built into the phone to the GPS. And on top of all of them sits math, okay? Remember math.
Even before you wake up, you're asleep on this amazing foamy material designed by engineers that doesn't squish and responds to different stresses and forces applied, giving you a good night's sleep. Putting this amazing piece of material on your toothbrushes, which flows like a fluid, but then sits like a solid on these pokey things and doesn't go through it. Physical sciences is the field of rheology that helps you understand how things flow and don't deform.
When I think about the physical sciences, particularly in the podcast, we begin to go beyond my expertise and we've had to be interdisciplinary. We have an episode called Rhythm in Blackness. It's the genetics of rhythm. I know a lot of genetics. I know nothing about the connection between hearing and movement. And so I needed to reach out to some neuroscientists, music ethnologists, and their question could be totally different. How does your ability to listen to music and take in music impact your mental health? And that gives now a whole new angle to this question. So it's really important that we bring in all these different fields of science to kind of answer one question, because more than likely they're all represented in it.
Physical sciences, to me, helps feed into those basic human aspects, curiosity and problem-solving nature. By communicating our work, we kind of challenge other people to take a second look and remind them that we still don't know much and it's okay. So that's physical sciences to me. There's a puzzle everywhere.